Philadelphia, 1787. At the Constitutional Convention, the framers struggled to design the presidency.
The delegates had to vote 60 times before they could agree on what the presidency would look like. What the delegates were trying to do was to create a powerful executive, but not one that was so powerful that he could become a tyrant. That was not an easy balance to strike. Now, for just about the whole summer, the plan was the president would serve 1 7-year term and be elected by Congress. But the delegates were never happy with that, because that would not be an independent executive.
In early June, James Wilson first offered the idea of an electoral college.
This mold would produce more confidence among the people of the first magistrate than an election by the national legislature. He shall hold his office during the term of 4 years.
But it would not be until September, with a proposal from the Committee on Postponed Parts, that would ultimately shape presidential elections. Previous debates had favored appointment of the president by Congress. But as John Dickinson later recalled, the committee devised a very different and highly elaborate scheme for electing the chief executive.
I do not pretend to be exact as to words.
Dickinson arrived late to a committee meeting and was troubled by the vote he missed that had assigned Congress with the duty of choosing the president.
The powers which we have agreed to vest in the president are so many and so great that I do not think the people will be willing to deposit them with him unless they themselves are more immediately concerned in his election. That he should be, in the strict sense of the expression, a man of the people.
But direct election of the president by the people was opposed by too many of the delegates to ever stand a chance of success.
Gouverneur Morris immediately said, "Come, gentlemen, let us sit down again and converse further on this subject." James Madison took a pen and paper and sketched out a mode for electing the president.